डिमोनेटाइजेशन इन इंडिया। प्राइम मिनिस्टर नरेंद्र मोदी सडन अनाउंसमेंट टू डिमोनेटाइज ₹500 एंड ₹1000 नोट्स इन सर्कुलेशन टू वेलकम बाय पीपल अक्रॉस द कंट्री हैज लेफ्ट मेनी इन द लर्च। डिस्पाइट फेसिंग द ऑपोजिशन आयर द प्राइम मिनिस्टर इन एन इमेंस प्ली ऑन संडे अर्ज द पीपल टू सपोर्ट द मूव वाइल आस्किंग देम टू बियर द पेन फॉर 50 days to help him deliver the India of your dreams. He also warned that several other steps were in offering to curb the menace of corruption. But what is demonetization? Demonetization is a additional monetary step in which currency unit status as a ledger tender is declared invalid. This is usually done whenever there is change of national currency replacing the old unit with a new one. Such a step, for example, was taken when the European Monetary Union nations decided to adopt euro as their currency. However, the old currency was allowed to convert into euros for a period of time in order to ensure a smooth transition through demonetization. Zimbabwe, Fiji, Singapore and Philippines for other countries to have opt for currency demonetization. Demonetization in India by PM Narendra Modi. On November 18, Prime Minister Modi in his televised address to nation made 500,000 notes invalid, saying that it was aimed at curbing the disease of corruption and black money, which have taken deep root. People holding notes of ₹500 and ₹1000 can deposit the same in their bank and post office accounts from November 10 till December 30. All notes in lower demonetized of ₹100, ₹50, ₹20, ₹10, ₹5, ₹2 and ₹1 and all coins continue to be valid and new notes of ₹2000 and ₹500 were introduced. There was no change in any other form of currency exchange, be it check, DD, payment via credit or debit card, etc. Demonetization brought learning for children. In the wake of recent demonetization drive by the government, Indian parents have reported guiltily breaking open their children's piggy bank for small change to tide over the cash crunch. After initial shock of seeing their piggy bank broken, children have been only too happy to oblige, given the promise that the money will be replaced with double the amount taken. As the country slowly comes to grips with the impact of this move, it is great time to impart some life lessons to impressionable young minds. Why saving and conscious living is important. Most children treat their parents as an ATM and think that pocket money is also for spending and not saving. While small children want every toy they see, teenagers' demand for gadgets and expensive products is never ending. This is why teaching your child to save for a rainy day is essential. Help them make conscious choices about how they spend money. Is what they want value of money or their better alternative available. The importance of cashless society. This is a good time to teach children the basics of banking, financial management and how daily living can be managed without cash. Talk to them about the pros and cons of using credit cards, the difference between debit and credit cards, net banking, digital wallet, how you can pay bills and order groceries online. Stress also on the precaution to be taken with each medium, like keeping password and PIN safe and protection from digital fraud. Familiarize them with the importance of paying taxes. Per a report released by Income Tax Department, only 1% of total population of 123 crore Indians paid tax of assessment year 2012-13. Imagine if all Indians paid their taxes honestly and there was no corruption, how much money would be available to improve the roads, bridges, airports and other development work of the country. everyone is equal in the eyes of law. The long queues for cash outside bank and ATM have blurred the class divide. Rich or poor, everyone is affected. The limit for exchange of old notes with new, deposit of old notes and withdrawal of money is the same for everyone. Anyone breaking this rule will be fined and will have to give the government tax on earnings they did not declare earlier. Black money versus white money. When people pay tax to the government on money they earn, the money is called white money. When people do not tell government about how much they earning, don't pay tax and hard cash, it is called black money. Even fake notes made to look like real money are called black money. The government introduced demonetization to remove black money. So we can't go to border to protect our country like our soldiers. We can do our bit by fighting the war against black money. 1978 demonetization. The government's move to demonetize even then was to tackle the issue of black money economy, which was quite successful at that point of time. In January 1978, the government demonetized rupees 1,000, 5,000 and 10,000 rupees notes, which was quite successful at the point of time. The move was enacted under the High Demonetization Bank Note Act 1978. Under the law, high demonetization bank notes caused to be legal tender after January 16, 1978. People who possess these notes were given till January 24 the same year a week's time to exchange any high demonetization bank notes. The main difference between then and now is that the currency of higher demonetization was barely in circulation, unlike the rupees 500,000 note today. Demonetization is not sufficient. In 1978, demonetization was carried out in India, but the policy did not end black money. In fact, black money possibly increased over time thereafter. So this time again, the demonetization announced on 8 November 2016 may not and or even significantly dent black money, unless there are structural reforms in the rest of economy on a sustained basis to reduce black money. There is a need for stricter collection of taxes and further simplification of tax laws and reasonable regulation in areas such as real estate, foreign trade, remittance, political donation, mining and gold. That incentives to deal in black money in the first place for minimum. How demonetization of India is different. In India's case, the move has been taken to curb the menace of black money and fake notes by reducing the amount of cash available in the system. It is also interesting to note that this was not the first time the government of India has gone for the demonetization of high value currency. It was first implemented in 1946 when the Reserve Bank of India demonetized then circulated rupees 1,000 and rupees 10,000 notes. The government then introduced higher demonetization bank notes in rupees 1,000, 5,000 and 10,000 in fresh avatar 8 years later in 1954, before the Morarji Desai government demonetized these notes in 1978. At the end of the day, your action and how you explain the ongoing situation will leave on lasting impact on the young mind you who will decide the future of the country.